What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. Hope you're all having a good day. We're on a 36 win streak, starting here with Eden, as we normally do. All right, we have two hearts, good damage stat, okay tier rate, little Steven. I'm way too scared that this pill is going to be a health down, so we're going to wait on it. And we have the D, what is this? The D, what is this? I don't really know. We got a dapper haircut, you know, there's that. It might be reroll. Well, it's every room. I don't know. Reroll rewards or something? I really don't know. I don't think it's reroll enemies. I don't think that's an every room type deal. But we did get a bomb, and if we go back here and right up here, we'll see that there is a tinted rock. You guys might have thought. I didn't see it, but I did. My peepers were peeping. That really sucks, actually. I was banking on a soul heart there, and we didn't get one. There is another chest here that we can access. Just some more red hearts, which may come in handy. Hopefully they don't. Hopefully we don't need to fill up these red heart containers. But, yeah, guys, hello? What the hell? What happened on that soy milk episode? Thank you guys for the support. And we cracked 30,000 subs and then hit, like, 30,200 almost instantly after. I don't know what is going on, but I appreciate all the views, the support, the likes, everything that you've been doing for the series. It's helping the channel grow, and for that I appreciate you. And the Battleground series is kicking harder than ever, and I'm super inspired just to do YouTube right now. I know it sounds silly because of all the YouTube drama that's been going on, like with the monetization stuff. But yeah, dude, just super inspired to do YouTube, and it's thanks to you guys. So we get piggy bank. This is an XL, by the way, so we really don't want to take red heart damage. I would like to get that. One bomb for 99 bombs seems like a pretty good trade. Okay. These stone fatties, dude. Alright, I think we just got out of that somehow. That was a very tricky room with a mushaboom in it. We don't have a trinket, so why not? Again. Okay. Jeez, man. All these mushabooms giving us a run for our money. All right, let's check out the shop. And indeed, we have a soul heart. I know I should buy a bomb considering it would get me, you know, 99 bombs. But worst case scenario, we could always just hurt ourselves. I hope we don't have to. Ragman champion on the first floor here is not ideal. It's not really what we want to see, but I think this is the one that just spawns. I don't think he shoots. He might shoot. Could be the famous last words that he doesn't shoot. But we're handling him pretty well. This champion version, if it is the one I'm thinking, which by and large this is what it seems like, he just kind of spawns. That version is a lot easier than the other one. Okay, we're going to get range up. Which isn't great. We do want a bomb here. Okay, we just got to make sure the brimstone guy doesn't hit us. Keep enough distance to where we don't have to overlap the creep that he's putting down. And well done there. All right, synth oil, damage up. And then we get Abaddon as well. Which we could take both. I'm pretty sure we could take both, because we take this one, and then we take this one. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby! All right, I'm taking Paperclip over Swallowed Penny. I just like Swallowed Penny. I'm sorry, I just like Paperclip better than Swallowed Penny. Let's go here. We could get 99 bombs, because we could fly now, courtesy of Lord of the Pit. That was an insane deal with the devil. That was all we could have really asked for there. And considering we could take both of them because Abaddon gives you black hearts in return, it all worked out. It all worked out real well. I mean, a lot of that had to do with the dodging on the mushaboom rooms. You have to think, if we never dodged like one of those mushabooms, we would have been in a bad spot, man. We would have not had to deal with the devil there, and we would have missed out on Abaddon and flight. Which could have changed the tide of the whole entire run. Some more money. Okay, we'll blow him up. Just because? Wow. Wow. 15 cents from that dude? What? What now? Try down here. Super secret room. And then the rich get richer with three black hearts here. And then an extra bomb back. Just because. You know, why not? We have 23 cents. Is there anything in here? We'll take Nun's Habit because we can. And there is a Tinted Rock here. We can access now because we have 99 bombs. And we got a bomb back with a key. The key is actually huge. Considering bombs aren't a worry, but keys kind of are. They're not completely sorted, so getting that is huge. All right. Well, that was an amazing, amazing first floor. Granted, it was an XL floor. It was an amazing XL floor nonetheless. I think our tier rate is the only thing really holding us back here. Our damage and everything else. And maneuverability and all that just seems really good. I don't know how I didn't get hit there. I still don't know what this freaking dice does. Thank God we have flight on this room. I hate this room. This room without flight is very, very difficult to not get hit at least once. You know, you probably get hit once or twice, but you have black hearts. Probably going to clear the room anyway. We'll just hold on to paperclip for now, I guess. Do we try it in this room? Okay, hold on. It might be reroll enemies. You know, I never know. Okay, a key for a key, bomb, and a couple coins. That seems like a fair trade. Yeah, it's reroll enemies. It's definitely reroll enemies. Now, is this a good decision? Probably not, but it's interesting. It makes it... They can't, like, move. We got, like, a Pac-Man situation going on here. I just realized this is the Pac-Man level. Yo, my brain is melting. My brain is melting. This is the Pac-Man level. This is Pac-Man. This is an ode to Pac-Man, the video game. My brain is melted. Okay, but seriously, this guy is very confused. All right, we got him. That was actually not bad. That was probably one of the few rooms reroll enemies is like a good play. That was a room that, like, Pac-Man-esque layout was a room that is made for those guys that pop up and pop down type of guys. And the fact is we re-rolled them, and then the enemies that we re-rolled into were granted harder enemies, but they were confused because of the layout and couldn't really maneuver around. So like I said, it's one of the few instances where it actually worked out for us. And this didn't re-roll the Fat Bats. So this is quite a disaster, actually. I'm actually not going to even mess with that room. There's no point. It's not connected to anything. But yeah, I mean, reroll enemies is... It's normally not good. Like, in that scenario, it was not good. I wanted to get out of the Fat Bats because they're so tanky. Not necessarily hard, just tanky. And then it actually rerolled into two harder enemies and then two Fat Bats as well, so... There's that. Okay. Well, we have a 67% chance to get a deal with the devil. We can kind of, you know, walk around here and try to figure out a way to get a better chance. Blow up, you know, keepers, beggars, whatever you got to do to get a better chance of a deal with the devil. Could happen. 67% could turn into 73% or something. I like those odds better. Speed down sucks, but we do have Lord of the Pit, so I don't know. Is it an actual speed down? Lord of the Pit, aren't you just stuck at a 1.5 speed? Isn't all flight just 1.5 speed? I don't think it can change. I think that's just how it is, if I'm not mistaken. But as you can see, our tier rate is the only sore spot right now. We are shooting tiers very slow, making our DPS just not that great. All right, well, there's Fate. Do we want Fate, though? I don't think so, because, well, I mean, it would give us an Eternal Heart, right? Do we want the Red Heart, though? I don't think it matters at this juncture. It's still so early. I'm just thinking I hate Fate's wings, like, legitimately. Cosmetically, those huge-ass white wings can get in the way sometimes. Like, Lord of the Pit's, like, bad enough with these wings, but I don't know if it's necessary. I really don't know if it's necessary. Might seem crazy to not take it, because it is a free red heart, basically, but... I don't know, I guess we'll just take it. I guess we'll just take it for the Eternal Heart. Oh, the White Wings aren't as big as I remember. What am I thinking then? I mean, they're still kind of obnoxious, but they do just replace Lord of the Pit, even though they're kind of glitching out right now. They're really glitching out, actually. We'll take the Celtic Cross. Celtic Cross? The Boston Celtic Cross? Gold Bomb. Best pickup noise in the game, low-key. Low-key flame pickup noise. Woo! Okay, just gotta get the host. Got the host, and then we'll check out the store. And we'll blow him up for a better chance at a deal with the devil. And a nickel. And then we'll buy deck of cards, because I'm really, like, kind of good on, I'm good on reroll enemies. That's just such a silly spacebar item. Deck of cards will just pop, and we get a devil card, which we haven't fought the boss yet. So we will take the devil card into the boss fight. I almost went to that room on the left. Good thing I didn't. No spacebar items. I don't know. I think we're good. I think we're good. We will use the devil, though, because it is Gertie Jr., who's not necessarily, like, the hardest boss ever, but can hit us, can definitely hit us with those charges, even though when he's feared, he's like, ooh, completely useless. He got unfeared real quick there. All right. 72% chance, and we whiff on the deal with the devil. I know there's a two of hearts back there. I'm not too torn about it. We did whiff on the deal with the devil. But maybe it's a blessing in disguise, because now we have a red heart and 100% chance at a deal with the devil. We need, like, Coat Hanger, Torn Photo, Sad Onion. Any of those would be great. My man just ran right on the spikes. Just ran right on the spikes. Mini Monstro, hello, friend. Jim Nance here. Shout out to Jim Nance. You know, the Masters are on today. It is Sunday for me. Probably not for you. Me mentioning Jim Nance and the Masters, I always talk about how, like, when I mention wrestling, it appeals to probably, like, 10% of my audience. I think I just appealed to 2.5%, no less, like 1.5% of my audience by mentioning the Masters and Jim Nance. All right, there we go. Sorry. Had to clear the throat. Didn't want to do it on the mic just because it's obnoxious. All right. But yeah, there's something about, I don't like golf. I'm not a golf fan. I mean, I liked golf when Tiger Woods was in the sport. He just made the sport more interesting, straight up. But, like, I don't go out of my way to watch golf. But on Masters, like, on the Sunday with Masters, you got to throw it on, right? You hear the birds. You hear Jim Nance's voice. It's just, there's something calming about it. It's like the best. And this is not even shots at golf. Like, it's the best way to take a nap on Sunday is when the Masters are on. And it's just, oh my God. That's the best nap you'll ever have. Dude, I'm telling you. Even if you don't like golf, throw that shit on. It's beautiful. They should sell. Like, you know how they sell, like, those radios that have, like, white noise or, like, the noise of, like, the ocean waves or, like, rain hitting the roof. Like, one of those options should be Jim Nance calling the Masters. And like I said, Jim Nance is one of the best play-by-play guys of our generation. No doubt about it. But, dude, let me tell you, that shit will put you right to sleep. It's a beautiful thing. All right, we got the virus. We got synth oil. We're we're just going to blow them up. We are one syringe away from spun, which is exciting. I would love to have spun. I ran right into that. It was so stupid. Just killing these mushrooms. By the way, me and Kate did a cooking stream last night. We actually did two cooking streams in a row. I don't know what came over us, but yeah, on my twitch.tv/wolvesatmydoor, we did a cooking stream last night, and it actually went really well. You guys should go check out the VOD if you haven't seen it. I would suggest the homemade pizza one over the chicken parm. Just because the chicken parm, it was good, but it was all mobile. It was all my phone. Like, I literally was holding my phone the whole time because the internet went down right when we were about to do the cooking stream. So I had to use the LTE on my phone to stream. But we did a homemade pizza stream last night, and we used, you know, the two webcams, The setup was legit, man. It was legit. And we cooked homemade pizza. It was really fun. It's like a 3-hour long stream. You could go skip through the VOD, check it out. I want to do more streams like that. I think it's such a fun platform, Twitch, you know, because you can get away with doing stuff like that. Like, I don't know. People seem to really enjoy it too, which is awesome. But yeah, I plan on doing more IRL stuff, especially because me and Kate are taking a trip to Universal and hopefully going to Harry Potter World Land, whatever you call it. Yeah, it should be a good time. So we have the Empress. We popped it to a clubs, which actually does nothing for us considering we have 99 bombs. These tanky-ass little mushroom heads. They're not tanky when they show their face, but otherwise they are. Which I guess is understandable. They're not vulnerable in that position. Alright, we got Gimpy. We got Nuns, Abin, and Gimpy. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Let's see what this pill is. I feel like this is the pill I started with. I think it was. Yeah. I think it was Verp, and then, I mean, Speed Down is the last pill we've taken, so. It makes sense why they just gave us a Speed Down pill. That's how Verp works. No Tinted Rock there. We have gotten our item room, and it was Gimpy, duh. It was just there. But as you can see, man, I've said this like 3 or 4 times. Our tier rate's bad. Our tier rate's straight up bad. Like, we're only shooting one tier every once in a while here. We really need one of those tiers ups that I mentioned earlier. Like, real bad. Let's check out the shop. We have 11 cents. Okay, trinket. Trinkets or cards? I think I'm going to roll with cards. I mean, not really the best of options there, but options nonetheless. You got to weigh them. I mean, you gotta use the bombs at this point. Bombs are like accounting for most of our damage, as sad as that is. There's Torn Photo. Let's go. That's just what the doctor ordered. We can get Spectral Tears or Sand. I think Spectral Tears, right? Spectral Tears is good. I know we already have Flight Guys. I'm completely aware. I'm doing that just for the Spectral Tears. And we could probably take Sand, but knowing me, I won't use it, so let's not do that. We can also check out this Curse Room if we want. We can also see if there's a Secret Room. Maybe right here? Nope. Wouldn't be right there. Maybe over here? Nope. Wouldn't be there. It actually could be attached to this Curse Room, which would be cool. It could be. It might be. It is. Could be, might be, it is. Hero font's amazing. I mean, that would, it kind of makes me want to take sand, but I don't, I just don't use it as much as I probably should. Hey, our speed went down to 1.4 instead of 1.5. All right, well, we're taking Pandora's box. I think it's a better idea for the future. Instead of just having random cards, I like cards, I do, but I think that the chance of getting 2 boss items in the womb is gonna be better for us. There's just so many spots where a super secret room can be. I mean, maybe here. Nah. Maybe here. Maybe here. Oh, we got it. We got it! Okay. 2 of clubs doesn't do anything for us. Let's just blow him up just for the memes. And yeah, let's move on. That's a solid floor as well. I mean, the Spectral Tears is good. I think the biggest upgrade there was obviously Torn Photo. It was a -6 to our tier delay. Like, we had a 15 tier delay and now we have a 9 tier delay. That is a huge, huge, huge upgrade. We were very stagnant when it came to tier rate. I mean, we do have Spectral Tears. It doesn't mean we have Penetrative Tears, so these guys are still kind of annoying. Nothing we can't handle, though. Little Steven's been on this journey with me since day one. I respect you, Little Steven. I respect you, bud. No other familiars want to show their damn face. You're holding down the fort. Yeah, if we get penetrative tiers and like another tiers up, it's over. I mean, I still think we're in an insanely good position right now. But to call it a win, hello? What? Two of the same exact rooms right next to each other? I've never seen such a thing. I thought it was Curse of the Maze, but the... freaking... Oh, God. The chest was locked again. After I clearly just opened it. It was super weird. It's funny, when you shoot a bomb like that, you're actually, like, hurting yourself a little bit, because you can't hit them when the bomb is sitting right in front of them. Okay. Sisvis is about to be dead. Zed's dead, baby. Not ideal. Definitely not ideal. Luck up, though. One makes you larger. We got an Empress speed down. We could just take this pill. There is a Demon Beggar. I don't know how much... That's so stupid. I don't know how much health we have. Yeah, dude, that's legit just the same room right next to each other. Let's check out the shop. We do have 36 cents. Nothing really. Get some more money just because we should have another shop on the next floor. You never know. We might not. Okay, this room, the fact that we can fly makes this room basically easy peasy. Alright. Let's go check out the Demon Beggar. I have no idea how many red hearts I have. But I think this would take a black heart. Alright, that spun right there. That was huge. That was definitely huge. Okay. So this should be a library of sorts. Oh no, it's Isaac's room or something. I don't know. We'll check it out either way. It is Isaac's room. This is a clean room. This should be a trap door. Indeed it is. Probably filling up our red hearts right now. There is a pill back here I would like to check out. Infested. All right, let's check out the trap door and soy milk. Okay, well then. if you so desire, game, I will take soy milk. Why not? I like soy milk. I like soy milk just fine. So we've gotten not our item room. We got our shop. We got the Isaac's room. Okay. We do have Curse of the Maze, though, which even makes that whole situation up there even weirder. Since the game wants to give us a donation machine, we'll take advantage and donate as much as we can, even though there was one in the shop. If it presents itself like that, might as well do it. I just ran right into that freaking brimstone shot. All right. Now we want luck-based items. So we have a 1.6 luck, which isn't too bad. So we want items like, you know, Holy Shot. We want Tough Love. We want Apple Trick or Treat one. We want all those. Taking a lot of damage. I mean, we do have soy milk. It's not ideal, but I love soy milk, and I will take it. Again, Spectral Tears is good for instances like this. Little Brim is great. Too bad he's gonna be a little behind in the in the lineup of familiars, so gonna be a little harder to aim than he normally would be. Oh yeah, feels good, man. Feels good, man. We have paperclip, so this is free. It would be kind of irresponsible to not try it or check it out at least. Oh, he got himself caught in the little corner there. Well, this is penetrative for sure. All right, that went really well. A bunch of consumables, another soul heart. I'm okay with that. I am okay with that. All right, let's just peace out. We got Isaac's room. We got the shop. We got the item room, and we already killed the boss, so just go down to the next floor. We're still waiting on popping this Pandora's box. I'm gonna wait till the womb one to do it, and we have a ton of health, so we should be good. Let's check out in here. I don't know what this is. Fate's reward. We'll take them. Why not? We already got fate. Now we got fate's reward. It just seems like this run is fate, you know, to win. If you could change your fate, would you? Oh, Merida. Oh, Merida. Okay, this is the skeleton hands. Just be careful of that. Little Brim's a huge damage dealer for us, if that's not apparent. I like our soy milk, though. Constant dealing of the damage. could use bombs there, but we're so close to max HP. I don't even think it's worth it. Our room clearing is pretty damn quick. Whether it's, you know, me and the soy milk with the spectral tears or, you know, Little Brim, it's just, it's fast. I don't really care who's responsible at this point. Just feels good, man. Oh, that was satisfying. All right, so we don't know what items we're going to be picking up here, but we'll pick them up nonetheless. And this is the Dank Depths 2. We are going to be fighting Mom here. We are missing Boss Rush by 4.5 minutes. It's okay. I'm not a huge believer in you need Boss Rush to make things work. I think this run is doing just fine on its own. Tears down? Does that really affect us? I don't know if it does. It might. It might affect us. I can't tell. We're still at a one tier delay. Didn't change anything on the stat sheet. We got Lost Fly, by the way, which, you know, he tries to do his thing. He sometimes works out. If you fight Mama Gertie, dude. You fight Mama Gertie, he's money. Or he can be money, I guess, if you wait long enough. Check out the shop. We'll just buy both of these items. Stopwatch, box of friends. This is tempting because I could double Little Brim, but we've waited too long for this payout to take box of friends right now. Kind of unfortunately, because I do like box of friends and I think it would be awesome with double Brim. I mean, double Little Steven, double Fate's reward as well. I don't think a sticky nickel is super worth it for us right now. All right, time to fight Mom. We'll pop the Empress card just because. It didn't even turn our tears red. What's the deal, man? What's the deal, man? Give you the gift of Jericho. Drink it in, man. Isaac. I mean, let's be real, Little Brim is carrying us through this. And the Empress card probably helped a little bit. All right. Mom is dead. All rejoice. We'll take the Polaroid. We didn't hit on the deal with the devil, but good news. We could pop Pandora's box finally and see what it has to offer right now. And not great. Not great at all. Do we even want that heart? I don't even know if we want that heart. I mean, this was all really not worth it. And then a half a soul heart out of the golden chest? What are you doing? What are you doing, game? It was like we gave you Abaddon on the first freaking floor. Get over it, dude. Fair point. Fair point. Touche, game. Abaddon really isn't the be-all, end-all. I think that's... Abaddon's definitely one of those items I think is really, really good, but I also think is overvalued in most scenarios. Like, I feel like Abaddon is usually, like, the... is a beautiful topper to your run, you know? It's like, if you get it late, it's usually really good. It kind of just, like, you know, makes you way more OP than you already are. But as, like, a starting item, Abaddon isn't, like, the be-all, end-all, for sure. It's usually good for, you know, health-wise. I'm going to take Pinky Eye here. And I really don't know if I'm going to take that Red Heart. I understand that we have a deal with the devil waiting in the wings. But is it better to do one heart or two hearts? I want to be able to get to Polaroid invincibility. It's a hard call. I think I'm going to take it. I'm usually a big advocate. Actually, we haven't fought Krampus yet. What does it matter then? If we fight Krampus, we're still not going to be able to give away our one red heart to get to the Polaroid invincibility. So what does it matter if it's Krampus? We might as well just take the other red heart. You never know. If shit gets dire, at least we'll be able to refill one of our hearts if we, you know, get that low. Small Rock, come on. Not necessarily. And for, I mean, this alone, it's worth it. All right, well, we'll just play this a little bit more. Why no Polaroid? Oh, is it because we weren't at a half heart or something? That's right. We got him to pay out anyway. Let's see if this guy pays out. What do we want from him? I don't really know. Compass? Is it too late for Compass to even matter? Oh, he paid out with something I didn't even know I wanted. All right, Crooked Penny. I'm okay with this. Let's grab this half heart. We also could basically go in here for free because we have a soul heart up there, so let's do it. Relax. Range down, okay. All right, let's go grab this other soul heart, and we got Pill Baby, which is interesting. And we got Crooked Penny, which is also interesting. What can we double? I usually always bank on doubling the shops, but since there's no shops, what do we double? What do we freaking double, boys? I mean, we could double the chest. That's a definite. We could do that if we so desire. Trying to think. Also, I took Pinky Eye over... Because we have enough keys to access the chest now. So I took Pinky Eye over Paperclip. I think it's time to switch it up. Plus, as you can see, we're getting some nice poison damage. That's usually what happens when... You have soy milks, things like this, it's really good when you get little trinkets that, you know, add poison damage because you have way more of a chance to shoot a poison shot, even with like a push pin or something. Like you're shooting so many tiers that you have a chance of shooting one of the trinket tiers more often. So, you know, things like push pin and pinky eye are a little bit more valuable when you have something like soy milk. I'm gonna run this dude into Lost Fly. You're about to be the hero, Lost Fly. Look at him go, dude. All right, let's clean up the rest here. Pill Baby's gonna be dropping a ton of pills, which I'm not opposed to. Let's just say, bruh, curse of the maze. Love me some soy milk, dude. Love me some soy milk. I love soy milk on certain enemies. Like enemies like that, the nub guys, like they have no chance. They can't even grow to the size they need to be to even shoot. Soy milk on guys like this, like Lust, that really suffer from knockback. It's a little much. It's really hard to aim your shot. Okay, a health up and then a verp. That's basically two health ups. Do I even want health ups though? I don't know. Let's see what this guy pays out with. I don't really know what I want from him, but... Okay, I sacrificed myself for this idiot. Hopefully it's worth it. Maybe we could double whatever it is he drops. I don't really know what he could drop for us to want to even double, but... Like, does it even matter if you double this? Just for the memes? For the memes, dude. Two fanny packs. Nice. Knockback is real on that guy. Alright, we got a big room up here, and then we gotta be getting close to the freaking boss. I feel like there's been a long ass womb! It's only the womb one. Unfortunately, I mean, I guess not unfortunately. What would it have mattered if we doubled latchkey? And I guess I'm thinking more in the terms of like, oh, if we had a per throw, we could double and get two pedestals and then reroll those two. You know what I mean? Like, then it would be sick. One makes you larger. Sure, if that's what you want, game. We did lose the health up. I'm assuming it's right here. It is right here. Perks. Okay, I don't think we want that. Damn, that teleported us pretty far. That's the normal secret room, I believe. So we still have a super secret room out there. Oh, a luck up, hello? Hello? I'm not proud of it. I'm not proud of it, guys. I'm not proud of any of the damage I've been taking, but we've been taking some silly damage. Speed down, health up, verp. Again, we could get two health ups because of this verp. Let's just go. I freaking never fight this arachnid guy. Ever. It's so rare. I'm not mad about it, though. I like switching it up. Okay. Well, that was pretty quick. Tears down. No thank you. Thanks, but no thanks. Okay, well, there's Sin Robes. I mean, it's gonna fill up our HP, which is nice. Do we, like, do I even mess? We could get a ton of red hearts right now, but do I even mess with that? I mean, they want it to happen, it's gonna happen, right? So we do this, we do this, we do this, we do this, we do this. I'm kind of doing this just for fun because we have so many opportunities to get so many red hearts that I figured why not. And now we have five red hearts just out of nowhere. Two tears down pills, I'm good. It's going to be a no for me, dog. All right, here we go, womb two. I figured, hey man, we're not going to get into the Polaroid unless we hit on this 33% and give away the last red heart. So let's have some fun and just, you know, juice up our red hearts. We never play with red hearts. And we had a very interesting opportunity there to Crooked Penny some HP ups and to verp a health up pill. It was just, things were working out for us, you know? So might as well. Okay, Guppy's Tail. All right. I don't think we have any other Guppy items, but I'll take Guppy's Tail considering it'll give me a bunch of chests. And I like a bunch of chests, especially when we're on the chest. I still think we're slightly underpowered. Okay, the amount of red hearts now are getting out of control, but we'll just do it. You know, why not? Why freaking not? Like, we're definitely underpowered for the womb. How am I still running into pills that I haven't seen? Seems insane. I don't really want to play this guy. Just blow him up. Sure, some money, why not? All right, I would like to, you know, Crooked Penny another pedestal. I mean, that's why black hearts are good for instances like that. How are there still pill? Oh, that's actually just a question mark pill. Okay, got it. I'm an idiot. Oh man, I was really hoping I was going the right way. We don't want to backtrack on the womb at all. Come on, bro. All right. Curse of the Maze tossing us every which way, but the right way. Okay. All right. Hey, that was pretty good, actually. Still one more. All right. Let's go fight Mom, or It Lives, whatever you want to call it. It Lives, formerly known as Mom's Heart. The artist formerly known as. Thank God for Little Brim. I don't know how you want me to dodge that exactly. So we missed on the deal with the devil opportunity. An infested pill. We might as well just pop and go up to the cathedral. I mean, we're really not in the best position. We're really not. We don't have permanent forward invincibility, which is huge on the later floors like this, because it prevents you from getting hit numerous times on each floor. But this is the path we chose, man. It wouldn't have mattered if, like, we would have still had one red heart, so we still wouldn't have had permanent polar invincibility. So I'm not, like, salty about taking all those HP ups. Plus, we do have a lot of red heart containers, therefore, if we find red hearts on the floor, we should be fine. For instance, that red heart there is important. It's not important right now, but it could be important. Having red hearts just around on the floor is good. Again, black hearts are great. We also have stopwatch, which is awesome. I don't know how the hell I didn't get hit by that guy. All right, that was handled pretty well. Algiz might be actually valuable for this Isaac fight. Well, definitely will be valuable. I think we'll use it on the Isaac fight is kind of what I was getting at there. Take advantage of the spectral tears. There's more? There's another one? Where'd that guy come from? Alright. Feels like we're going the right way. Let's just hope. How many times are you gonna see the tears downpill? Holy hell. Two of these guys is always trouble. There's a lot of RNG based on this fight. You don't know because of the bombs could bounce off each other's bombs and easily hit you, but we made it out without getting hit. I'm okay with this. Sun card is actually huge. All right, this is good, man. This is good. I mean, you can't really complain when you have Little Brim. You really can't. Like, Little Brim can just carry you. I think our soy milk tiers are pretty good. Honestly, I think Pinky Shot is helping us out more than we know. Another health up for the memes. Yeah, we can use an Algiz here. Why not? I mean, we don't have an orbital, so Algiz is not as good as it normally is. Algiz does always last a shockingly long time, though, when you think about it. All right, now it's going away. All right, we got him more than halfway down. We got him out of his harder phase. The only problem with this phase is that I don't think we deal enough damage for him to actually not be able to shoot. You know what I mean? We did get hit there, but getting hit means you get slowed down. A little bit easier to dodge these attacks when he gets out of that first cycle of tears. Oh, Lost Fly almost was the hero. Oh, Lost Fly! Oh! Good job, bud. Good job, bud. Alright. We're gonna kill him. Easy peasy. And we have a Sun card. We also have Crooked Penny ready to go, which... I don't know. We'll see. We'll open all these and see if any of them are worth trying to double. None of them are that good on their own. We might as well just try to double them. Okay, never mind. Hopefully, considering we have, considering we have... What am I trying to say here? Oh, Guppy's Tail. Considering we have Guppy's Tail, we should be able to get more chests here, which means more items. Hopefully. I don't know. This double Monstro fight isn't great. I mean, thank God for stopwatch. Okay, one's down. Okay. Ooh! Let's check out the secret room. We do have mapping, so we know exactly where we're going. Nothing doing there. All right, I mean, it's not an easy path, but at least we know the path instead of going back and forth. I mean, double cage room, double, you know, Monstro 2 room. They're definitely giving us the juice right off the bat here. Need the little brim hits as much as possible. All right, one cage dealt with. That was unfortunate. Stay as far away as you can. Be able to dodge it a little bit easier. Woo! All right. Second cage down. Like I said, Monstro 2 and then like some double cages. Not the easiest, so we've definitely gotten some harder fights out of the way. Not to say double gate is necessarily easy, especially with those insane brimstone shots that you can't really tell where they're coming and where they're going. Oh, I was like, what is shooting like that? I thought we had lead pencil, but it's just mini Monstro. Alright. Some concentration and dodging there is all we needed. Lazarus's Rags is actually pretty good for us right now, considering we don't know where this run's gonna go. Still think we're underpowered for the room that we're on. Okay, I know the other one's a lot lower than that one. Think the other one died? I'm gonna go with yes, the other one did die. Just got a couple slugs here. Again, Guppy's tail really paying out. One makes you larger. I can't say no to a one makes you larger pill. Just not in my blood. Or one makes you smaller pill for that matter. Oh, we must have. Oh shit. That guy. We gotta keep that dude alive, dude. He just roasted and toasted Envy there. We have so many familiars all of a sudden. I think it's Wheel of Fortune that blows up into the item, not Temperance. All right, three more rooms to go. Again, we got the harder ones out of the way, it seems. This one not so difficult. Mini Monstro is honestly doing some work here. It's funny because he's kind of on the same time as Little Brim, which is working out pretty well. Pill Baby just giving me the range down pills. All the range down pills a man needs. Two of Hearts basically just solidified this win. I don't think there's anything that could stop us now. Two of Hearts, that might have sounded sarcastic, but honestly, with all these Red Heart containers, that just solidified the win. Basically, if we get hit a ton of times, we could just double our Red Hearts when need be and then get back to full HP, basically. So, yeah, the Two of Hearts just solidified this for sure. I mean, it was looking good for a while here. It's just when you're underpowered and you don't have Polaroid invincibility, things can get out of control and out of control fast, especially when you don't have things like the wafer to basically make each hit only half a heart. When each hit is a full heart, you know, your 9 health can fade away very quickly, more quickly than you think. Oh, well. Hey, we got some kind of invincibility. I mean, the stopwatch all but solidified this as well. This is gonna be another W. What is this, 37, I think? That's insane. That's insane. We're up to 37, if not 38, I don't know. We gotta check after this. It's hard to tell sometimes. All right, one last hit. Well done there, Blue Baby. Well fought, good fight, good night. And let's see, we have a win streak of 37, 37 indeed. We will be back tomorrow with another Eden streak. Oh baby, that felt like a long one, huh? 50 minutes, yeah, it was a long one. All right, hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, feel free to leave a like. If you haven't checked out these two episodes listed down below, make sure you go check those out. Make sure you subscribe in the middle for more daily Isaac content. Thank you guys so much for the support on this series. You've been nutty. And, yeah, until next time, stay safe, stay up, peace out.